The reduced operation is pretty clear. So the idea is at this level, we have a full resolution or whatever level, and then we want to take the next level down. So here's a way of thinking about it. We'll just number these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 pixels across. I actually don't have to produce the pixels that would go under 2, 4, 6, and 8 because I only want half the number of pixels that I had to start with. So in fact, what this does is it simply says I'm going to take some location, here I use the middle, and I'm going to take what's called a 5-tap filter, and here are the filters. See, it's 1/16, 4/16, 6/16, 4/16, 1/16, and that's what these numbers are. 1/16, 1/4, 3/8, 1/4, 1/16, okay? That's the filter that I use to get the odd pixel here in the middle. Now, that's just in one scan line. I'm working with images. How do I do this? Okay, go way back in your notes, because I know you're all taking copious notes. I almost said y'all. When I say y'all, Megan's going to throw that monitor at me, okay? Nothing against my friends from the South, but I come from New York, went to school in Boston. If I actually said y'all, I think I'd get shot by my relatives. Anyway, you all have seen this before. We talked about separable filters, right? So a separable filter was, instead of applying a square filter or a 2D filter, I apply one one-dimensional filter horizontally, and then often it's the same one-dimensional filter vertically. So go back up and remember about separable filters. The reduce operator uses a separable filter, a 5-tap separable filter, first in the rows, then in the columns. All right, that one was straightforward. The expand operator is a little bit trickier. And you can tell that by looking at this awful picture. In fact, I'm going to pull that awful picture out by itself. Here's the deal. The idea is that on this picture, only pixels that were real. The question is, how do you make finer pixels from a coarser level? So here's the coarser level, here's the finer level. And it turns out you do it two different ways, okay? So we're going to start with the odd pixels, all right? So the odd pixels occur underneath pixels that are actually there. So there are a couple of ways of thinking about this. One is we're just going to assume that I'm just tell you what the filter is, right? That it's 1/8, 3/4, 1/8. Okay? That seems a little bit arbitrary until you realize that's just kind of like if these were zeros, okay, and I took in all the values here, and I made it the same 5-tap before, but now doubled it, so 1/8, 1/2, 3/4, 1. These would be in the same ratio of 1, 4, 6, 4, 1 as before, okay? But I'm only pulling it off the odd pixels, all right? And so these points go away, and I'm only left with 1/8, 3/4, 1/8. By the way, we're going to provide the original Bert Adelson paper that talks about reduce and expand, so you'll be able to look at that a little bit more carefully. All right. That's to reproduce a pixel that's actually underneath one that's there. Slightly trickier are the even pixels. We have a pixel here that's underneath something that didn't actually exist. So if I still do the 6-4-1, right, 1-4-6-4-1 above me, okay, well, when I'm on one of these even pixels, there's nothing directly above me, and there's nothing to my ends. There's only these two here. That's this one and this one. So looking 5 above me, only 2 of them are really there. They're equally distant from me. What coefficients am I going to use? I'm going to use 1/2. So to produce this finer value, I take 1/2 of that pixel and 1/2 of the other. And that actually sort of makes sense. If you think about it, if I'm blowing up a picture, so I'm going to go from, say, 7 pixels to 14, I have to get space between 2 pixels that were there. What value should I put in that space? Halfway between the ones that were there before. Okay. The one that's a little trickier to understand is if I'm blowing it up, how come I just don't leave this original pixel alone? And you can read in the paper, this is for the odd pixels, you can read in the paper the motivation in terms of frequency theory in terms of how they do that. All you need to know is that you now have a reduce operator and an expand operator.